In this video lecture, we are going to see multiple input, multiple output systems and the important definitions which are part of the MIMO antenna system used in determining the capacity of wireless channels. In current wireless network scenario, especially in 4G networks, MIMO based systems play a major role in improving the capacity of wireless channels when compared with traditional single input, single output systems. The topics covered in this lecture are MIMO systems, array gain, diversity gain, data pipes, and spatial mux. MIMO systems, multiple input, multiple output systems. It was first implemented by AT&T Labs, New Jersey. Initially, they performed some field tests in order to characterize the mobile MIMO radio channel. The company measured the capacity of a system by placing 4 antennas on a laptop computer and 4 antennas on a rooftop base station. Here, the transmission is done from laptop and reception in the base station. They have observed 4-fold increase in capacity when compared with single antenna system. The frequency band used for testing was 30 kHz with dual polarized spatially separated antennas in both base station as well as laptop. This figure shows the transmitter with 4 antennas on laptop. This figure shows 1900 MHz coherent transmitter. This figure shows 4 receiver with real-time baseband processing. This figure shows rooftop antennas. Multiple antenna is used for both transmission and reception. This increases the capacity of wireless channel. Capacity is the maximum achievable data rate for an arbitrarily low probability of error. There are different antenna configuration. They are SISO, single input, single output, SIMO, single input, multiple output, MISO, multiple input, single output, MIMO, multiple input, multiple output, MIMO-MU, multi-user, multiple input, multiple output. Now let us see what is single input, single output. Here the transmitter and receiver of the radio system have only one antenna. SIMO, single input, multiple output. Transmitter has one antenna while the receiver has multiple antennas. Hence, we get more samples to determine the received signal. MISO, multiple input, single output. Here the transmitter has multiple antennas and receiver has only one antenna. MIMO, multiple input, multiple output. Here both transmitter and receiver have multiple antennas. MIMO-MU, multi-user, multiple input, multiple output. Here the multi-users interacts with one or more antennas. For example, mobile towers. Next, let us see what is array gain. It is the average increase in signal to noise ratio at the receiver that arises from coherent combining effect of multiple antennas at the receiver or transmitter or both. Transmitter array gain. If the channel is known to the multiple antenna transmitter, the transmitter will weight the transmission with weights depending on the channel coefficients, so that the receiver received the data coherently. For example, MISO. Receiver array gain. Here the receiver can weight the incoming signals so that they coherently add up at the output, thereby enhancing the channel. For example, SIMO. Now let us see what is diversity gain. Increase in signal to interference ratio due to some diversity scheme. There are 3 types of diversity schemes: temporal diversity, second one frequency diversity, third one spatial diversity. Now, what is temporal diversity? It is the transmission of same transmit signal at different times at same channel. It is effective when the channel provides sufficient variation in time. Here, the coherent time is smaller than interleaving symbol duration. Two channel codings are used in this transmission for sending replicas of signal. They are forward error control coding and time interleaving. Forward error control coding is the process of detecting and correcting bit errors. Time interleaving, it allows the use of ADC to process regular sample data series at faster rate. Next, let us see what is frequency diversity. Transmission of the signal on different frequencies. It provides replica of the original signal in frequency domain. Here the coherence bandwidth is smaller than the bandwidth of transmitted signal. Now let us see what is spatial diversity. The spatial diversity is otherwise known as antenna diversity and space diversity. Here several antenna elements are separated in space. It is an effective method for compacting fading. Here the antenna spacing is larger than coherent distance to ensure independent fades. Traditional types of diversity schemes are selection diversity, maximal ratio diversity, equal gain diversity. Next, let us see what is received diversity. Maximum ratio combining is a frequently applied diversity scheme in receivers to improve signal quality. In cell phones, it becomes costly. Transmit diversity. It is easier to implement at the base station. It requires complete information at the transmitter. Space-time codes for MIMO uses both transmit diversity and receive diversity with high quality of reception. Here a scheme is used named to be ALMOUTI scheme. There is no need of knowing about channel, hence the transmit diversity can be done easily. In spatial diversity, there are two more types of diversity. They are polarization diversity and angle diversity. Polarization diversity. Horizontal and vertical polarization signals are transmitted by two different polarized antennas at the receiver. Different polarizations ensure there is no correlation between the data streams. Next, let us see what is angle diversity. Here the carrier frequency should be greater than 10 GHz. Transmitted signals are highly scattered in space. Receiver can have two highly directional antennas facing in different directions, which enables receiver to collect two independent samples of same signal. For example, dish antenna. Next, let us see what is data pipes. It is derived from fluid mechanics. Pipes are used to transfer water to a tank. The more the number of pipes, the greater the quantum of flow of water into a tank. Now let us consider two data pipes between transmitter and receiver. Case 1, data in data pipes are identical to each other. Now the result is decreased throughput, diversity and correlation. Case 2, independent samples completely different from each other. Now the result is increased throughput, no diversity and no correlation. Now let us see what is spatial multiplexing. It offers a linear increase in transmission rate for the same bandwidth with no additional power. Let us consider two transmit and two receive antennas. The bit streams is split into two half rate bit streams modulated and transmitted simultaneously from both the antennas. Receiver have complete knowledge about the channel. The receiver provides receive diversity, but the system has no transmit diversity. The spatial multiplexing increases the transmission rates proportionally with the number of transmit receive antenna pairs. Now let us see some more important definitions in order to determine the capacity. Define automatic request for repeat. It is the error control mechanism in which received packets cannot be corrected or retransmitted. This is a type of temporal diversity. Define forward error correction. It is the technique that inserts redundant bits during transmission to detect and correct bit errors during reception. Define coding gain. The improvement in SNR at the receiver because of forward error correction is called coding gain. Define interleaving. A form of data scrambling that spreads burst of bit errors evenly over the received data, allowing efficient forward error correction. Define multiplexing gain. Capacity gain at no additional power or bandwidth consumption obtained through the use of multiple antennas at both sides of a wireless link. Thus, the MIMO is an effective technique as it improves capacity as well as diversity.